students, welcome to School of Political Science, and today our topic is what is political theory. We will learn this topic through these steps. At first, what political theory is, then type of political theory, then decline of political theory, and at last, revival of political theory. Before discussion about political theory, we have to clear that what theory and political actually mean. Political. The word political mainly refers to power or authority. It is something related to a polity that is public, as distinguished from private or something applicable to a limited number of persons. Theory. The word theory derives from Greek word thoros, which means a spectator. Theory is a set of assumptions, propositions, or accepted facts that attempts to provide rational explanation of cause and effect relationship among a group of observed phenomena. Theory stands for a systematic knowledge of a particular phenomenon. So, what is political theory? Political theory denotes a systematic knowledge of political phenomena. Political theory is a personal endeavor to understand and experience the present political reality and also to evolve a mechanism in order to transcend the present imperfect society leading to perfection and a more just order. Thus, includes a study of the evolution, nature, composition, need, and purpose of the governmental apparatus and also an understanding of human perception and nature and its relationship with large community. Definition. The view of Catalin is that the word theory is like a blank check whose value is its utility and the way in which it is put into practice. Arnold Brethard has defined theory as a proposal which is expressed in terms of some data and supports some ideas. Andrew Hacker writes in his Political Theory that theory has broadly two meanings. One of the meaning can be closely associated with traditional political approach, which the other with modern. In this traditional sense, he means history of political ideas, while in the modern sense, this reference is to modern political behavior and its scientific study. According to David Held, political theory is a network of concepts and generalizations about political life involving ideas, assumptions, and statements about the nature, purpose, and key features of government, state, and society, about the political capabilities of the human being. Types of political theory. There are mainly two types of political theories: normative or prescriptive and empirical or descriptive theory. Normative theory implies systematic thinking about the purpose of government. It is kind of practical philosophy as relates to government. It chooses not to concern itself with what was and is but preferred to contemplate on what ought to be. Normative theory focuses attention on ethical questions or values like good order society and end of the state, etc. It is prescriptive and value-loaded concept. Plato's Republic, Aristotle Politics, Rousseau's Social Contract, Machiavelli's The Prince, these are in this category. And empirical theory is primarily concerned with things like state structure, political process, etc. as they are. It wants to study politics by focusing attention on the individual and group behavior and also what goes on in political process and within political institution. Empirical theory based upon observation. It is descriptive and value-free concept. The prominent exponent in this category, the Graham Wallace Human Nature in Politics and Arthur Bentley's Process of Government. Decline of political theory. It is generally claimed that the decline of normative political theory, that means value-oriented political theory, set in with the advance of science in modern world and the revolutionary achievements of science and technology. In the middle of the 20th century, many observers were ready to write an obituary on political theory. Some spoke of its decline, like Cobham, Easton, and some proclaim its death, like Laszlo Dahl. One referred to political theory being in the doghouse, like Reimer. David Stern has mentioned four main factors responsible for decline of value-oriented political theory. The first factor is historicism, by which he means undue emphasis on historical studies or merely trying to understand the factual conditions. The contention of Stern is that throughout the 19th and 20th centuries, modern writers did not use the history of values to stimulate new thinking or new values. And that explains why since Karl Marx and J.S. Mills there have been no outstanding political philosopher. The second factor is moral relativism and scienticism. Moral relativism and scienticism emphasize the need for social scientists to be neutral between different values and treat them as mere expression of individual or group preferences. The third factor is the craze for science. Political scientists and behaviorists advocate the importance of studying what is actual behavior and claim it to be more important than the study of what ought to be. And last factor is hyperfactualism, that emphasizes on the obsession with facts, their mere collection and enumerations. Since the 1920s, the main interest of political theorists shifted to the development of new techniques for the collection of data and for understanding voting behavior, public opinion, and legislative leadership. Stone described this phase as one of theoretical malnutrition and surfeit of facts. According to Alfred Coben, bureaucracy and military organizations and machines are external conditions which have given a serious setback to political theory. To Germino, in his book Beyond Ideology, the Revival of Political Theory, identified two major causes of the decline of political theory. First is the rise of positivism, which led to the craze for science, and second is the prevalence of political ideologies culminating in Marxism. Ischia Berlin and S.M. Lipset attributes the decline of normative political theory to the triumph of democratic social revolution in the West. Revival of political theory. Political theory in the traditional sense was alive in the works of Arden, Theodor Adorno, Herbert Marcuse, Leo Strauss, and Oakeshott, etc. According to Arden, the uniqueness and responsibility of the individual human being with which she initiated her criticism of behaviorism. According to Oakeshott, philosophical analysis of experience which resurrect the multidimensionality that was denied to experienced by positivism and ideology. According to Strauss, all political theory was ideological in nature, mirroring a given socio-economic interest. Thank you friends for watching these videos. For more videos, please subscribe our channel.